Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. On today's feature, we've got two Notion updates for you. One is mainly for the teams out there that are looking at Notion to see whether they can qualify for this new opportunity. And the second is some exciting updates for the platform for those who are already using Notion. So today, let's dive in and learn more. So guys, it is November 12th and today Notion are launching Notion for Startups. So this is an exciting opportunity for startups because Notion are offering a $1,000 discount on the team plan for any of the startups that are involved in over 50 incubators. Those incubators include 500, Techstars, and Y Combinator, and many more across the world. You can actually find whether you qualify as a startup in the incubator or accelerator that you're in through using the link below. Now, this is really interesting because already a lot of startups are using the platform as a way to, you know, organize all of their information. Actually, we've got one use case from the startups from Christine Tan from Deal. Deal is a payments service, and as you can imagine, they're using it to organize how they work as a team. So here's a little snippet from how Christine and her team are using Notion right now.
Deal is a payments and compliance solution that helps pay your remote team wherever they are. So we do the streamlined compliance, simple payments, and automated invoicing, and it doesn't matter where your team is based because we do it internationally. There's also a lot that goes into this, which is why we use Notion to organize everything within our team. Everything's always accessible and viewable among team members, and for me, within compliance, it allows me to store our 101 docs, legal notes, policy notes, and more. We also have pages for product, marketing, sales, and HR. Product will use Notion to track things like bugs. It's also where I'll keep and create product documentation. We use this to track feedback from users, and it's also where the product team will keep their meeting minutes. Marketing will have copy, content, growth ideas in their page, and then sales will use Notion to keep track of leads, hold our email drafts and sales sequences. And the HR team is really important because it's accessible by everyone, which allows us to make sure that our team values are seen. And because we're remote, this is really important for us. Policies around vacation and expenses are there. And we can also learn about where other team members are and a little bit about them as well. I also like to use the personal notes section, which allows me to just throw in random notes about a call or a meeting to have something on record of what we spoke about. And I don't need to think about organizing it into the whole team Notion. And yeah, that's a quick summary of what we use Notion for here at Deal.
Now, I definitely think this is an exciting move from Notion, introducing it into students and educators for free, and now introducing it for, you know, small tech startups, larger tech startups, and introducing that $1,000 discount is pretty impressive. They're obviously trying to capture those individuals that are obviously growing pretty rapidly, and it's exciting they're offering it. Now, I will be trying to get more startups on to share how they are using Notion. I believe this week, tomorrow maybe, we'll have Carson from Arcade, and he does an amazing tour of how he and his team at Arcade uses Notion, so do stay tuned for that. So guys, you're probably wondering, what's the second big update with Notion? Well, they have announced some performance and speed improvements on all of their devices. Now, they've highlighted that iOS, Windows, Mac, and web will be faster. You can find out more details on the What's New page, but this is great news. Now, one of the things that a lot of people have been struggling with is the speed of the mobile applications. Whilst I haven't tested this dramatically, I've noticed a gradual improvement in speed from updating to this latest version. Although I guess time will tell about how that experience will go. It's important that they've obviously flagged it as something that has been an issue, it has been a major issue, and they're looking to work on things like reliability, offline access as well. So it's all on the radar before they maybe release big features like Timeline in the future. Guys, if you're new to this channel, I'd love to have you as a subscriber. We obviously do tons of different content, Notion being one of those. If you're interested, you can check out the Notion Made Simple course, which is an 8-module course which dives into everything we need to know about Notion. We're looking to improve it every single month. So guys, it was great to have you today. Make sure to subscribe, and I'll talk to you guys super duper soon. Cheers, everyone.